जो है नो दैट पीपल आर विद अस नॉट ओनली फ्रॉम अराउंड पाकिस्तान बट ऑल्सो फ्रॉम अराउंड द वर्ल्ड. आई एम ऑल्सो वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू आर एक्सपर्ट स्पीकर जो है समीर अहमद साहब, माशाल्लाह ही इज ऑल्सो विद अस. थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस एंड टेकिंग आउट योर टाइम फॉर दिस एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक जो है विच आई थिंक सो इज इन एवरी वन माइंड एंड हार्ट दैट वट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इन द फ्यूचर एंड वट आर द इम्प्लीकेशन एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज.
सर प्लीज
जी
रिपीट फ्रॉम स्टार्ट प्लीज बिकॉज वो अभी हुआ लाइव.
ऑलराइट. बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन. आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स ऑफ दिस वेरी यूनिक सेशन इन व्हिच वी हैव आवर एक्सपर्ट स्पीकर समीर अहमद साहब विद अस एंड वी आर वेरी ग्रेशियस टू समीर अहमद साहब दैट ही हैज जॉइंड अस फॉर दिस एक्सट्रीमली यूनिक सेशन इन व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट the financial implications and consequent economy. I would like to appreciate all the people who have joined not only from Pakistan but also from around the world. And first of all, I would also like to introduce Ann Foundation, who have a student foundation, a social enterprise which was developed by socially conscious and very patriotic Pakistanis. They are doing many projects. They have developed a library in a school in a village, in Nangar village. They are developing a library, an electronic library for Farah Blind Association. They are also looking at many other libraries around Pakistan. They have done extensive relief work during the COVID crisis in Gujranwala, Lahore, and Burewala. And they have also arranged various talks and various sessions to create more awareness at all the levels, not only in Pakistan, but also abroad. So I would like to appreciate the management of Ann Foundation. The topic for today is financial impact and consequences of COVID-19 for Pakistan's economy and its people. This topic is the need of the hour. And just like mentioned earlier, we are very fortunate to have Samir Ahmed Saab with us, who mashallah comes with a wealth of experience of more than 25 years, both national and international. He has mashallah worked in the UAE financial markets and was there when the foundation was being laid for this mega boost forward, and then it changed the whole world. He's also been there as a senior advisor, and he's been the chief executive officer of Lahore Stock Exchange, of IGI Investment Bank and Pakistan Mercantile Exchange. And he's also an independent consultant. Not only is he in the practicum forum, but he also shares his knowledge and his wisdom and all the practical implications with the future of Pakistan as an adjunct faculty member of LUMS. And he also is currently the CEO of Knightsbridge Capital Group. Sir, thank you so much for coming over and thank you so much for joining us, sir. I look forward to a very invigorating and eye-opening and mind-opening session today. Sir, with your permission, I would like to ask the first question. We got a plethora of questions from many people. And from those plethora of questions, we have shortlisted a few questions. And naturally, I mean, I can understand that with your wealth of experience, we can talk for days on this topic and we can enrich everyone. And I actually really look forward to follow up on this session, maybe post Ramzan also, sir. I would just like to ask an opener question, that how do you see this disruption in the global value chain impacting Pakistan?
Sure. Thank you very much. First of all, it's a pleasure being here, and thank you for your very, very kind introduction. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. I've been in the financial sector for some time, and obviously, like everybody else, just trying to follow what's going on, just trying to get a grip. I don't think anybody has a grip right now because this whole crisis has been a bit sudden, and I think it's still evolving. I thought I'll just start off with a few numbers. Can I share a document on the screen?
Sir.
Okay, just to make sure that we're not... just to make sure that we're not completely, as they say, hawa mein baatein kar rahe hain. I'll just have one page which I wanted to share, and just to give credit, This is from Alphala Investments. This is an asset management company. This document was produced roughly 10 days ago. And I just want to go through some of the large numbers, especially on the external account, because, you know, when we're talking about the global crisis, these are some of the things that we have to look for. Can everybody see this?
Didi, very clear, very clear.
Great. Okay, so we have some the previous year's numbers. Let's start with the first row, which is the exports. This sal we had thought that after the rupee adjustment and everything, exports would grow by about 3% or so. However, the impact that we're seeing currently, a lot of export orders have been cancelled, and just a global slowdown aa raha hai. Uski wajah se, I think exports, they estimate that this financial year exports will be down to about 28.2 billion, which will be a 4%. This financial year obviously ends in June. So roughly a 4% decrease in exports, down to about 28 billion. For the next year, what Alphala is assuming is a 1/3 drop in total global trade. So as you know, is waqt sari supply chains ye wo sab jam up hui hui hain, economic activity bahut sare mulkon mein ruki hui hai. So the assumption Alphala has made is that global trade would drop by about 1/3. And their estimate is that our own exports will drop by 25%, down to about 21 billion ka yearly level. Moving on to imports, imports had been coming down very significantly over the last few years, as we can see, 67 billion, 62 billion. For this year, it is estimated at about 51.7 billion. And next year, a further drop in imports. There are two elements to this. Number one, obviously, again, that currency adjustment, because under the previous government, the currency had been kept at a very overvalued level. And so our imports were cheaper than they should be. So we were importing a lot more. वो एक adjustment हो गई है. अब इस वक्त जो एक इसमें you might say एक advantage है is obviously जो oil prices में आपने देखा है, come down to historic low levels. Well, historic in the sense कि we last saw these levels around 1999, 2000 when oil moved up from $10 a barrel. So anyway, again the assumption that Alphala has made is that if oil is at $30 per barrel, then our oil import bill falls by about half a billion per month, so about 6 billion a year. So the imports will go down by about 16%. Trade deficit overall jo hai stays roughly where we are at. Is waqt ye jo currency ki adjustment hui hai PTI government ke time mein, isse roughly hamara jo trade deficit hai that has come down to manageable levels. So there is still a deficit, mind you, but it's much better than it used to be. So from roughly about 40 billion is down to about 20, low 20s mein. So इस वक्त जो ट्रेड डिफिसिट है इस साल इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 23.5 बिलियन एंड दिस विल गो डाउन अ लिटिल बिट मोर नेक्स्ट ईयर टू द 22 बिलियन लेवल. दिस एज यू विल प्रोबब्ली ऑल बी अवेयर इज इंपोर्ट्स माइनस एक्सपोर्ट्स. सो द टोटल खसारा है हमारा ट्रेड का. इट्स स्टिल अ डिफिसिट बट इट्स गोना गो डाउन अ लिटिल बिट मोर. रेमिटेंसेस एज ऑलवेज आर अ सेवियर. सो रफली स्पीकिंग जो हमारा ट्रेड डिफिसिट है वो रेमिटेंसेस से फिल हो जाता है. वी हैव इनकमिंग फंड्स from overseas Pakistanis. Isme se mera khayal hai ki roughly 50% comes from the Gulf region and the other US, UK and so forth. Acha, ab trade remittances bhi, this is one of the positive points over the last few decades. They've been growing very, very rapidly. Now, given the global situation and given the situation in the Middle East with the oil crisis, oil prices which benefit us in some ways, but in the remittances, the expectation is very low growth for this year to about 22.5 billion and a slight decline for next year, about a 5% decline to 21 billion. This is, as you know, even now this process of a lot of workers being laid off in the Middle East, coming back home and so forth. Or in any case, jo laid off nahi bhi hai, economic activity is much lower, oil prices are much lower, so ek remittances mein discount aayega. So current account deficit has come down from around 20 billion levels to about 4 billion levels. Agle saal bhi roughly it will stay at about this 4.5 billion or so. This I thought just to give you you know some idea of the numbers and where we stand. So I would say overall is waqt jo external account situation hai, it's fairly stable. Jo all of the bad news is already in. Usme some of the bad news is good news for us. For example, on the oil import bill, उसमें दो चीज़ें हो रही हैं, एक तो इम्पोर्ट की प्राइसेस भी कम हो रही हैं, दूसरे हमारी यूजेज भी जो ऑब्वियसली विद दिस स्लो डाउन ऑफ इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी दैट्स गोना बी देयर। इस वक्त आई थिंक जो एक्सपेक्टेशंस हैं इस साल जीडीपी ग्रोथ की, दिस इज वी गोना गेट अ नेगेटिव नंबर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन आई थिंक सिंस द 1950s आई बिलीव। सो द एक्सपेक्टेशन इज रफली 1.5% नेगेटिव ग्रोथ इन आवर जीडीपी। क्राइसिस से पहले आई थिंक यू वर एक्सपेक्टिंग रफली 3% पॉजिटिव ग्रोथ। सो नेगेटिव ग्रोथ इज वेरी वेरी अनयूजुअल। हाउएवर इफ यू अगेन लुक एट सम ऑफ द अदर नंबर्स विच आर कमिंग आउट ग्लोबली, अ लॉट ऑफ डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज आर लुकिंग एट 15-20% नेगेटिव ग्रोथ, बट द नंबर्स आर स्टिल कमिंग इन। एज आई सेड एंड आई एम्फसाइज वंस अगेन, दिस इज अ इवॉल्विंग सिचुएशन। अभी भी आई थिंक हार्ड ग्रिप नंबर्स पे नहीं है लोगों को। हाउएवर सम ऑफ द नंबर्स विच आर कमिंग आउट आर हॉरिफिक। यू मे हैव सीन यस्टरडे for the month of April, unemployment rose by 20 million in the US. This is a month on month, 20 million, which is a phenomenal number. Is waqt jo unemployment number hai US ka is down to 15% unemployment. This is a number that has not been seen since the Great Depression in the 1930s. So it's roughly after 90 years that we are seeing this. 2008-09 mein financial crisis aaya tha, uske baad bhi jo unemployment numbers the were roughly 8-9%. So 15%, this is on the April numbers, is a phenomenal number, and it's a very bad number. So this is the situation everywhere. Hamare yahan bhi as I said, ye 1.5% negative growth, I think this is something that the IMF has come up with, and I think our government has at least verbally kind of conceded that this is going to be the situation. Now, going forward, do teen char cheeze hain zehen mein rakhne ke liye. Ek to ye hai ki is waqt jo behas ho rahi hai, this lockdown versus non-lockdown. Again, this is nothing peculiar to Pakistan. The entire world is going through this. Different countries have taken different approaches. The countries like New Zealand and China gone through a complete lockdown and more or less controlled the situation. There are other very interesting examples like Sweden, and for those of you who have not studied it, do study it. They went the opposite direction. They said it's important to build up immunity in the population. So we don't want a lockdown. All we're going to do is we're going to protect the more vulnerable, which is the older population and so forth. Unko protect karo. Baki population ko with precautions, with sensible measures, let people go about their business. Over a period of time, yes, there will be infections, there will be diseases, but overall, a population may immunity develop ho jayegi, and that in the longer run is something that will do. Anyway, ye ek behas hai, it's not conclusive. As I said, different companies have adopted different approaches. Some countries, I think, again, you're all aware, have completely messed it up, including, surprisingly, the UK and the US and a lot of Europe also. उसमें कुछ तो दे वर कॉट अनअवेयर्स कंट्रीज लाइक इटली एंड सो फोर्थ, बट उसके बाद भी ये जो इनके सामने एग्जांपल्स थे, सैड टू से नॉट अ लॉट ऑफ देम हैव डन वेल। देयर आर गुड एग्जांपल्स आउट ऑफ एशिया, साउथ कोरिया इज वन। दे डिड अ लॉट ऑफ टेस्टिंग। अगेन द आइडिया वाज के डिजीज को आप पकड़ लो, टेस्टिंग गिव्स यू अ लॉट ऑफ डेटा, कहाँ है, कहाँ कॉन्सेंट्रेटेड है, किस एज ग्रुप में, किस जियोग्राफिकल एरिया में, किस इंडस्ट्री में। So that allows you to then isolate those pockets and treat them and so forth. So South Korea seems to be a great example. Acha, hamare yahan is waqt ek wo lockdown ka period tha. Ab jo I think kal decision hua hai wo ye hai ki isko ease up kare. Because in economic terms, obviously there's this fundamental decision. And again, I would urge all of you to look at it with an open mind. Unfortunately, hamare yahan jo debate hoti hai, it's that lockdown versus lockdown. मीडिया के कुछ लोगों के अपने एंगल्स होते हैं, गवर्नमेंट का ऑब्वियसली एक और व्यू पॉइंट है। दिस इज़ अ वेरी वेरी टफ कॉल। सो ये कहना कि जी फॉर एग्जांपल एक डॉक्टर्स का व्यू पॉइंट है, द डॉक्टर्स आर इन फेवर ऑफ अ लॉकडाउन जनरली स्पीकिंग। नाउ द थिंग टू अंडरस्टैंड एटलीस्ट टू माई माइंड इज दैट द डॉक्टर्स आर गोइंग टू कम अप विद अ नैरो टेक्निकल व्यू पॉइंट, व्हिच इज एज इट शुड बी, एंड दे आर राइट टू एम्फसाइज दैट। यदि आप लॉकडाउन को ईज करोगे, डिजीज बढ़ेगी। गवर्नमेंट ऑन द अदर हैंड हैज टू लुक एट इट ओवरऑल पिक्चर। सो व्हाट दे आर सेइंग इज कि यस, we can lock down completely and try to control the disease. But that has a cost. That has a human cost also. That has an economic cost. And especially for a poor country, you cannot jam up all economic activity indefinitely. So unki koshish ye rahi hai ke precautions lein, jo sensible measures hai lein, to try and open up the economy in ways that you can. And it's been gradual. For example, pehle ye tha ki construction sector ko to phir kuch detail mein hai, ab kal kuch aur measures aayenge. On the other hand, you've got this center versus province thing going on in Pakistan also. So the news today is a bit confusing. From what I understand, the government has said kar do, but they've also left it to the provincial governments. And apparently, Sindh and also to a certain extent Punjab are not very much in favor of easing the restrictions. What the government has said, the federal government, is ke restrictions hum ease kar rahe hain, but at the same time, precautions have to be taken. At the same time, you've got to keep an eye and monitor the thing very closely. So if things seem to be going out of hand, if people don't take adequate precautions, then we may have to go to that lockdown, stricter lockdown again. So it's an evolving situation. It's a very, very difficult situation. Ismay ab jo do teen areas aa rahe hain, for example, let's take the agriculture side. I'm not an expert, but just briefly let me cover that. In fact, as you know, we're in the middle of that wheat harvesting season. Wheat is our biggest crop. Wheat is the staple crop. We produce roughly 25 million tons a year. Thodi si jo weather conditions, they were not favorable. I mean, we are loving the rain and the thunderstorms, but it's not great for wheat at this time. The expectation, I just talked to some people in the sector yesterday, expectation is ke possibly a 10% shortfall, so not a major disaster. लेकिन थोड़ा सा शॉर्टफॉल वीट की क्रॉप में आ जाएगा. वीट बाय द वे जो 25 बिलियन टन है, वी कंज्यूम मोस्ट ऑफ इट आवरसेल्फ्स, देयर इज अ स्मॉल सरप्लस, बट इट सीम्स दैट द सिचुएशन इज मैनेजेबल. इसमें थोड़े से इश्यूज आ रहे थे शुरू में, बट आई थिंक अगेन द गवर्नमेंट हैज बीन फेयरली प्रोएक्टिव. वन ऑफ देम वाज लेबर. अ लॉट ऑफ लेबर मूव्स टू द रूरल एरियाज इन टाइम फॉर दिस हार्वेस्टिंग सीजन. There's this little box which keeps coming up on the screen. I don't know if you can see it or not. Hamara wo right email ka chhota sa
hai. Anyway, it's not on this side. Ji.
Usme kuch labor ke issues se, partly because we're into provincial transport is waqt nahi hai. The other thing was regarding the, you know, the harvesting machinery and all. So I think machinery ki to transport government ne khol di thi, and I understand as of now machinery also moves in a seasonal way from Punjab, from Sindh towards the northern areas. So thoda sa harvesting season mein time lag aata hai. So I think that is underway. As I said, thoda sa wheat crop is a bit affected, but nothing serious from what I understand. Rice comes in later in the year. I think rice may we have surplus stock, and we are actively exporting rice as of now. Pulses ka bhi, I understand that the situation is under control. We've got 2 or 3 months worth of stock in Pakistan. Ek aur cheez is waqt agriculture mein aap padhte rahe honge is locust. Apparently is saal jo locust ki threat hai, that is very, very real. And this again is not a Pakistan thing, it's a regional thing, balki Africa mein bhi is waqt is saal for whatever reason the locust problem is going to be very, very large. Pakistan mein jo baat kar rahe hain, wo keh rahe hain maybe 5 to 10 times the normal locust ki jo population hoti hai wo banegi. Is waqt unka kuch attack aa gaya hai, kuch abhi bhi breeding season chal raha hai, kuch hamare yahan chalta hai, kuch I believe southern Iran is a large area. To southern Iran se through Balochistan, this is expected. Again, this is not something new, we deal with it every year. I think is waqt jo issue hai wo yahi hai ki resources ka, because a lot of resources are going into, including time, you know, the attention span of everybody COVID mein. So whether or not we're keeping an eye on the locust situation, isme do ek hi cheez ho sakti hai essentially. I believe spraying ho aur usko aap breeding stage pe pakad lo. To kal bhi main dekh raha tha shayad koi jahaz waaz aaye hain which will be doing spray. So anyway, that's a potential danger sign. जो दो तीन पॉजिटिव एरियाज मुझे नजर आते हैं, एक तो आई थिंक द टेक्नोलॉजी साइड, आईटी इंडस्ट्री, व्हाटएवर यू विश टू कॉल इट, दो तीन इसमें मेगा ट्रेंड्स हैं व्हिच आई जस्ट वांट टू ब्रिंग टू योर नोटिस. एक तो वी सीन इवन इन द कोविड रिस्पॉन्स द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ डेटा. आज बल्कि डॉन में बड़ा एक अच्छा आर्टिकल है फहद हुसैन का, इट्स वर्थ रीडिंग. दिस नेशनल कमांड एंड ऑपरेशन सेंटर, इट सीम्स टू बी अ वेरी ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एंड अ वेरी सीरियस एफर्ट. एंड आई थिंक फॉर द I don't want to make political statements, but I think this is for the first time I'm seeing in a government that there is a focused, concentrated effort. It's never going to be easy. Governments, the nature of governments is that X number of people will like you, X number of people will be amarenge ki aapne kya kiya. But it seems there's a very serious effort to study the data and to try and work out some kind of a sensible strategy to deal with it. Anyway, one of the key things is data. So apparently they're getting data, they're pouring over the data from all over the country, including I believe NRSP, because unki wo ek reach hai throughout the country, wahan se bhi wo data le rahe hain. Jo military ka apna intelligence ka apparatus tha, wahan se bhi data le rahe hain. So trying to make sense of it. So data, generally speaking, is going to be the big ones. And if I relate it to agriculture, for example, one of the issues which came up a few months ago was a wheat shortage. हुआ ये कि गवर्नमेंट की वीट की एक्सपोर्ट अलाउ कर दी एंड इट टर्न्ड आउट दैट द स्टॉक्स अगेन द डेटा दैट द गवर्नमेंट हैड वाज नॉट ग्रेट सो देन दे हैड टू से कि अच्छा शायद तो थोड़ी शॉर्टेज होगी और हम एक्सपोर्ट नहीं करेंगे सो अगेन दैट थिंग द डेटा इज वेरी एसेंशियल क्रॉप कितनी आ रही है ज्योग्राफिकली कितनी आ रही है यील्ड क्या आ रही है ज्योग्राफिकल मूवमेंट्स क्या हो रही हैं क्रॉप में दिन में तो शॉर्टेज नहीं है बलोचिस्तान ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स रिक्वायर डेटा. And I think one of the things that this crisis or any crisis does is it concentrates minds. Wo kisi ki kahawat hai, I don't know, people say Churchill ki hai, some people say somebody else's ki hai. They say that a crisis is a terrible thing to waste. So I think that's one of the things that if you have a positive, the positive would be ke ye itna bada crisis hai that it's concentrating people's minds. A lot of things which we took for granted. So the hope is that we'll do more on this side. So returning to technology, I think 3-4 opportunities hain. Ek to this meeting itself, for example, we're doing it online. All of you have been going through online classes in the last 2 months. So, you know, even if we go back to the old times, my own guess is that online teaching, online courses are here to stay. We've seen it in the rest of the world. Yahan pe bhi, as we get the hang of it, yes, it's not an ideal situation. So even if it doesn't replace or shouldn't replace, it can supplement what we're doing. Just talking from my personal example, 2 weeks ago, I needed to consult a doctor by first experience of telemedicine. This was with Shaukat Khanan. They said, ki ji, hum is waqt physical consultations nahi kar rahe, telemedicine. It was fairly basic, just a WhatsApp video call. I had my initial talk with the consultant for a few minutes. He had a suggestion in terms of kuch tests wagara, to wo ho gaye hain. Uske liye I had to go physically there. But the point is again, ke even if it's not going to replace, obviously depending on the severity and depending on the nature of the illness, you may have to see the doctor physically at some stage. But my point is that these areas, jo hai na, by default, we've gone through it. Again, taking my own example, working in an office, mere utility bills aate the, I'd give the cash to the peon or the rider, say, ja, bank mein jaake jama kara lo. Up for the first time, and it was there always, it's nothing new, I've subscribed to the online banking, so I pay my bills online. So ye cheeze jo hai, as consumers get used to it also, isme kafi, I think you will see growth, and there's room for you know, the technology industry as a whole, I think, to grow. My understanding is, I'm not from that field, my understanding is that there's a fair amount of work which is going on in the tech area in Pakistan. So I think you know, the thing will be there. The third area I just wanted to cover, again, you have heard in this crisis, is that the supply chains have been disrupted globally. So one of the mega trends which is coming out of the US and other European countries is that hamari bahut zyada concentrated dependence thi, for example, on China. So they will be looking to diversify their supply chains. Now, it's not possible to move all that manufacturing facility out of China, what's probably going to happen is that the new facilities which are going to come in are going to be more spread out. Vietnam is an example. Yesterday I was reading an article, I think Bloomberg, India has made a conscious effort in the last few weeks to reach out to these countries, including in the areas of pharmaceuticals, including in the areas of food processing, auto parts, and the traditional areas, leather and textile. And they're reaching out to these countries and they're saying, aap China mein the, ya aap China mein hain, please come to India. So if you want to diversify your supply chains, we have the capacity. We look at, there are labor laws ke problem, we look at those problems. There are, you know, other issues, taxation, we look at that. So I think this is, in terms of Pakistan also, this is an opportunity. Agar jo global supply chains mein hum kisi tarah fit aate hain, possibly to begin with in the more traditional sectors like textiles and leathers and so forth. And over a period of time, you could even look at things like engineering. Auto parts stands out. Auto sector has its own issues, but on the back of these three large companies, you've got an auto parts industry which is grown. So these are some of the I think opportunities that we can look at. Again, it will require an effort both on the part of the industry and on the part of the government. It's not going to happen overnight. We need a maybe 3-year, 5-year, 10-year plan. And then on our side, in our country, in our industries, we'll need to improve our quality. We'll need to improve our governance standards and so forth. Just one more thing, agri mein kuch baat hui. Agri itself, there is a lot of room for two things. Ek to efficiencies, aur dusri value addition. Efficiencies, so for example, if you look at our crop yields and all this, some of the lowest in the world, even if you compare it with other emerging markets. To isme kuch, obviously, mechanization ki taraf se hoga, better seeds, better imports, and so on and so forth, better credit perhaps. The other thing is a lot of our exports are, you know, basic commodities. Basic commodities mein danger yahi hota hai ke you have commodity prices globally, good times you get a good price, bad times you don't get a good price. So is waqt, for example, rice ki demand hai because India had stopped export of rice. So the major rice importers have been looking, and Vietnam and Pakistan have stepped up and they're saying, you know, we've got some good price. The other thing is value addition. My main job or my full-time job is private equity. One of the projects that we're currently engaged in is a value-added food project. This is for fruit pulp. The large story is that for health reasons, aerated drinks, the Cokes and Pepsis, are going out of style. People are more health conscious. People are moving more towards juices. इसपे गवर्नमेंट्स का भी कुछ हाथ है. आई थिंक सिंध और पंजाब ने दोनों ने एरेटेड ड्रिंक्स को बैन कर दिया है स्कूल्स में. सो यू कांट सेल दोस. आल्सो द प्रोविंशियल फूड अथॉरिटीज हैव नाउ सेड दैट इफ यू वांट टू कॉल दिस जूस यू नीड एक्स अमाउंट ऑफ फ्रूट पल्प. सो देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन फ्रूट ड्रिंक एंड फ्रूट जूस. सो इससे वो एक फिलिप मिल रहा है टू द जूसेस की इंडस्ट्री एंड वी ट्राइंग टू काइंड ऑफ फिल दैट. सो वी आर कमिंग अप विद अ प्लांट व्हिच विल make fruit pulp, and then we will sell that fruit pulp. For example, mangoes ka, I have the numbers. We produce roughly 2 million tons of mango in Pakistan, out of which only 100,000 tons is made into pulp. So there's a huge growth opportunity here. Achha, we've talked, for example, to the Nestle's and the Pepsi bottlers, and you know, all of these are in the fruit juices market, and you've got some local players like Frutien and Shizan and so forth. They're all looking for pulp. They're growing very fast, but they're saying that our constraint is for pulp. If we can get more pulp, good quality pulp, then we'll be able to grow more. Achha, isme jo, the thing I wanted to get at is, if you want to supply to Nestle, for example, you've got to have certain quality standards. You've got to have certain governance standards. Labor hai, unki safety, health, wagaira, wagaira. These are some of the things that will help us to grow into the export markets. It's not a question of saying, mere paas ye cheez hai. There are certain criteria and all that you have to meet, and these are certain things that you build up over a period of time. So agar ye value chain mein hame aana hai aur opportunity is very much there, we need to have a game plan. These are some of the 3 or 4 points that came to mind. I thought I'd just
I think so. A very elaborate and comprehensive Johanna overview of how the supply chains have been disrupted and how economies have been disrupted, and also the different opportunities which exist for Pakistan. And actually, your whole session has really motivated everyone that we have these opportunities not only in agriculture, but in value chain and also in the IT sector. And again, the oil gift that we are getting as a nation, that will also be helping us out. So maybe the pandemic, yes, has its own repercussions, negative repercussions, but if we are able to make the pieces of the puzzle put together in the right way with the right support systems, then definitely we can actually even emerge better in the coming years, I think. So that is what you have basically shared with us. But it all depends upon the government policies and how people get together to avail these opportunities which are over there. Sir, I would just like to know, there are other questions which are also coming up and I'm also writing them down. We shifted through many, but now we're getting many more. It just shows how interested people are. And I would just like to mention over here, sir, that we have many professional people from around Pakistan and around the world who are participating in this very interesting discussion of yours. And like I said, that I can understand how busy you are, but maybe we might have to request you post Eid for another follow-up session, because dynamics, just like you were mentioning, are unraveling in itself and the figures are changing very rapidly.
Yes.
I mean, I was hearing the other day, just like you were mentioning, that UK initially was looking at about 33% drop in its economy. And now they're reconfiguring those figures, just like you said. So they are thinking that maybe below 25%. So again, Diana, there's too much of uncertainty and ambiguity right now. Sir, I mean, you talked about many, many sectors which are there. I would just like to know that we also have another area, which is the CPEC. Johair, what do you see the future of CPEC in the future post COVID-19?
इसपे CPEC पे I think जो the broad picture is कि जो initial phase one था, which had a lot to do with certain infrastructure, including the most prominently the power sector and some connectivity and highways and so forth. अच्छा, इस वक्त प्री कोविड जो था, द थिंकिंग वॉज दैट वी नाउ नीड टू मूव ऑन टू द सेकेंड फेज ऑफ इट, विच हैड टू डू मोर विद द एक्चुअल सेटिंग अप ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज एंड मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड सर्विसेज एंड सो फॉर्थ. मिसाल के तौर पे वन ऑफ द थिंग्स विच वॉज गोइंग टू हैपन वॉज द सेटिंग अप ऑफ स्पेशल इकोनॉमिक जोन्स. अब उसमें चीज़ें आएंगी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल वेयर हाउसिंग इज वन थिंग, एंड देन द सेटिंग अप ऑफ एक्चुअल इंडस्ट्रीज विद इन दोज zones. Ab isme I think CPEC, like everything else, is a little bit hostage right now ke logon ki attention kahin aur hai. However, I think longer run that you know things stays. I think it's important right now, we're all subah se shaam tak covid hota rehta hai. It's important to get some perspective also. Yes, we're going through a very very difficult time. Eventually it's possible ke kehrein ki second wave bhi aaye, possibly more also. So we'll have to deal with it in the long term. But eventually we will get over this, whether it's through a vaccination or whether it's through building up immunity or whatever. And then, you know, as I said, life goes on. So I think the CPEC next phase, which is with the setting up of these special economic zones and also the setting up of actual industries. This may be not an expert, but one of the things that does come to my mind is that if supply chains diversify, or people are not comfortable with China in geographical terms, then possibly some of the Chinese manufacturing could move to a country like ours. In fact, this was our hope earlier also, because China, having reached a certain level of per capita GDP and technological proficiency, China is one of those interesting countries which move from here to here without going through that intermediate state. Usme wo bhi ab jo basic industry thi, jisme, you know, toys ho gaya, textile ho gaya, wagaira wagaira, the original sort of stereotype ke cheap Chinese maal, they have moved up. For example, it's like 5G China, is it? So the thinking was that as China has moved up that value chain, they may or wish to relocate some of their more basic industries to other countries. So that again is a possible opportunity that comes to mind. CPEC I think will going forward still remain a very very major undertaking both for us and for China. So is waqt thodi si iski baat nahi ho rahi, but I think possibly with the time lag of a few months, jo original CPEC ke plans the by and large, I think those will
जी, सो बेसिकली समीर साहब, व्हाट यू आर सेइंग इज दैट दिस वुड डोवटेल विद द डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ऑफ द वैल्यू चेन, जो है ना
जी,
वो पर्सपेक्टिव.
पॉसिबिलिटी है. अगेन इट डिपेंड्स ऑन आवर रेडीनेस, ऑन आवर कैपेबिलिटी, एंड आई मस्ट एम्फसाइज नॉट जस्ट द गवर्नमेंट बट आवर प्राइवेट सेक्टर आल्सो, दे हैव टू मूव. वन ऑफ द ब्रॉड पॉइंट्स आई विश टू मेक इज दैट आवर प्राइवेट सेक्टर हैज नॉट kept pace in terms of efficiency, value addition, and so forth with the rest of the world. And I think if you look at it, it's a very interesting statistic that you all may wish to look up, is our share of foreign trade as a percentage of GDP. This is imports and exports. We are one of the lowest in the world. Now, one of the measures of your efficiency, your capacity to add value, is how much are you exporting. You know, even if you're a large company in Pakistan, if you're not really exporting, it means that you're not up there in terms of your quality, your efficiency, your price, whatever. So yes, this opportunity I think is there. It's always there, but it depends how our companies and businesses respond.
Ji, excellent. So again, another window of opportunity exists over there, and do we open up the window or not? That is a very big question mark that we have to see in the future. And inshallah, yes. Sir, you were talking about the government, and we've talked about the international scenario and also the role of the private sector to basically benefit from the current scenario. What do you think about the stimulus package which has been given by the government? Because yes, there are opportunities for businessmen and everyone, but we have so much of poverty in Pakistan, and we have such a large youth bulge and also a very large labor force. In the current scenario, they have been very hard hit. And how would you look at the stimulus package which has been given by the government for them? Do you think it's adequate, or there's much more room, or whatever? So your perspective on take on it.
The isme, I think the one broad point I would point to, and again, this is I keep saying this, nothing is Pakistan specific. What's happening here is very global in nature. So I think 1.2 trillion ka stimulus package announced hua hai, but the message that keeps coming from the government is essentially we will do whatever it takes. So if this proves 3 months, 6 months down the line to be not good enough, I think the government is ready to step forward. I think there are some steps which are unprecedented, and again, it's not just here, everywhere. Misal ke taur pe aapne kal parson dekha hoga, SME sector ki lending ke liye the state bank has said that we are willing to take up to 40% of the losses. Now, the central bank never did this. Even if it provided financing at low rates, the risk was always the bank's risk. Yahan hum aapko 0% ya 3% pe paise dete hain, lekin agar loss hota hai, credit risk is yours. Yesterday, for the first time, the government has said, or the state bank has said, that we're willing to share that risk of loss. Acha, ab isme ki cheez wahi hogi ke banks obviously agar 40% government levy leti hai 60% unka hai, so they'll have to do that credit assessment. Whether this government, by the way, has state bank has announced a number of other measures also before this, in terms of for example, one of the things which is expected to happen, and I think it's happening even now, is that businesses, because of the slowdown, will not be able to service their loans as scheduled. So businesses will ask that you need 6 months or 1 year or 8 days. So normally what happens is the state bank has very strict regulations. If you have 6 months delay, then you have to make provisions in your balance sheet. So banks ko unhone ye wo chhoot de diye to take a slightly lenient view. There is a genuine problem in the economy, sub-sectors, so take a lenient view. The government, I think state bank, has also announced low interest rates, the funding they'll make available. Acha, ab iska end of the day practically on the ground effect hota hai ya nahi hota, again this is one of the things we'll have to see, but this really will depend on the banks. For example, one of the things that we fault the banks here, and rightly so, is that they have not really reached outside the big mega corporates, you know. So if let's say, I'm just taking two examples to give examples. I have nothing against these companies. Let's say Nishat wants to borrow, or Indus Motors wants to borrow. I think auto companies don't borrow. They have more than enough cash. But let's say Nishat or Sapphire or a large undertaking which has been around for decades, they're able to access bank financing easily. The SME sector has not. Traditionally, they've always faced problems. The banks are very, very reluctant to lend. Again, it's like the larger story is that banks are making good money by lending to the large corporates as well as by lending to the government, because the government is a big borrower and the government is by definition a risk-free borrower. तो बैंक्स के पास वो कैपेसिटी नहीं है रिस्क असेसमेंट की लेंडिंग की. नाउ इज दिस समथिंग दैट यू डेवलप इन 3 months? नो, दिस इज समथिंग दैट अगेन यू हैव गॉट टू हैव दोस सिस्टम्स एंड प्रोसेसेस. सो आई थिंक द की थिंग विल बी कि अगर गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से स्टिमुलस या स्टेट बैंक की तरफ से स्टिमुलस आ भी गया है, वेदर और नॉट इट ट्रांसलेट्स टू द सिचुएशन ऑन द ग्राउंड. सो आर द स्मॉलर कंपनीज, द मीडियम साइज कंपनीज, आर दे एक्चुअली गोइंग टू गेट दैट फंडिंग? दैट्स गोइंग टू बी द की. So again, my point earlier, that government can do a certain amount. Uske baad that the private sector, whether it's the banks or industry or whatever, they have to step up. They have to deal with the situation. Government ne apni taraf se ye zarur kiya, which again is, I think, I don't know. I'm sure other countries have done it also. But you know, this ehsaas thing, putting 12,000 rupees. Into the pockets of 12 million families. That's 144 billion rupees. This is again, I think, one of those shining examples. Yes, people will complain ki mujhe lineon mein laga ya mera arzi reject hogi. Whatever, there will be issues. Obviously, it's a huge undertaking. And I think ye pure 12 million abhi hue nahi, but ho rahe hain over a period of time. But the fact is that millions of families have actually received cash. 12,000 rupees for a poor family is something, I think this is like a 3 month thingy, which is enough to, I mean, it's there for a subsistence level kind of thing. So it's a big help. So the government has actually gone directly to the people and put this money in their pockets. Baki jo hai, as I said, it is for the banks, the private sector, the industry, commerce, whatever, to respond. Also, acha, by the way, this brings me to that earlier point about data, the importance of data. The reason why the ESAS system works is because that database is there with the government. Ye jo ek Nadra ka project tha 10 15 20 saal pehle aaya hai. By the way, this data is it's again worth something. Aap log behtar mein se jante honge, but I understand when somebody applies for this, it runs through certain filters. For example, they'll check your travel record, they'll check your mobile phones, they'll check whether or not you're a government employee. So you have to go through these filters. So the idea is that undeserving people should not be able to get this money. Yeah, so a broad point, government can do something. Yes, you could ask ke shayad kuch aur karna chahiye. But I think all sectors have to respond. Government ki taraf se ek jo cheez which is glaring right now, and this is something which has happened over 70 years, is, you know, just the underinvestment in the health sector. Is waqt emergency war footing pe some things are being done, but I think this is something which stands out, and again, not just in Pakistan, globally. The health sector, ye sare capitalism ke chakkar mein, health sector is an area of underinvestment. So I think going forward, this is one of the things you'll see everywhere, is that government should be forced to spend more.
Ji, so Mir Saab, just adding on to what you were basically talking about, the role of the state bank and how it has also very proactively engaged with the business sector and into the economy, what is your viewpoint about the rate cut that they have given? Do you think it is appropriate, or we still require to have more rate cut in the given circumstances?
The rate scope again, you have to see it in the right perspective. The reason the rates went up to 13.25% is because inflation went up to, at one stage, 14%, and then that was a monthly spike. But 11-12% peak inflation thi. Now it's again, all of you would be familiar with this term, that interest rates have to be, in real terms, they have to be positive. So if you've got 10% inflation, then interest rates have to be 11% or 12%. अच्छा, इस पे भी अब वो जो एक वो डिमांड होती है कि कम करो कम करो कम करो, इफ यू हैव नेगेटिव इंटरेस्ट रेट्स, देन आई एम गोइंग बाय प्योरली ऑर्थोडॉक्स काइंड ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, इफ यू हैव नेगेटिव इंटरेस्ट रेट्स, देन यू आर पीनलाइजिंग अ सर्टेन सेक्शन ऑफ सोसाइटी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई एम अ सेवर आई हैव मनी टू सेव और 12% इन्फ्लेशन है मुझे अगर सिर्फ 10% मिल रहा है आई एम बीइंग देयर इज अ ट्रांसफर ऑफ रिसोर्सेज फ्रॉम मी टू द बोरोअर्स सो जो स्टेट बैंक की एक स्टेटेड पॉलिसी थी इंटरेस्ट रेट्स इसलिए हाई हैं क्योंकि इन्फ्लेशन हाई है. अच्छा आप दो तीन चीज़ें हुई हैं पिछले एक महीने में. एक तो इन्फ्लेशन हैज़ कम डाउन सडनली अ लॉट ऑफ इट इज़ ड्यू टू ऑयल प्राइसेस अ लॉट ऑफ इट हैज़ टू डू विद द डिमांड कंप्रेशन लैक ऑफ इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी दैट इज कमिंग. सेकेंडली बिकॉज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ द क्राइसिस इस वक्त इन्फ्लेशन इज नॉट सो मच अ कंसर्न सो द गवर्नमेंट हैज़ ब्रॉट डाउन सो टू थिंग्स हैव हैपेंड. Number one, the actual inflation numbers have come down. And State Bank, by the way, always goes not on actual numbers, but on expected numbers. Because monetary policy is always forward-looking. So expected inflation has come down very drastically. It may come down some more. Secondly, is waqt jo hai, emphasis policy ka thoda sa aur hai. Wo ye hai ki ya jitna kam ho sakta kar to, so that economic activity can start getting generated. So yes, I think what the State Bank has done is good. Whether or not 9% is the level or 7% is the level, it's difficult to say. I mean, that people who, you know, say 15% or 0%, but I must emphasize, ye log hawa mein baatein kar rahe hain. The State Bank has to have some kind of policy guideline, whether it's inflation or some other number. It has to be well thought out a policy or guideline. Achha, is way again, my sense is, from the State Bank also the message has gone out that whatever it takes. So, you know, we stand ready. Agar halat kharab hote hain aur agar mazid cuts ki zarurat hai, so the possibility is that those cuts will be there. But again, it has to be well thought out.
Sir, another very important institution of which you have also been the chief executive officer, and that is the stock exchange. Where do you see the stock exchange going, let's say, in the next 1 year? And what role does the stock exchange have to play in this whole recession?
I you know, when somebody asks me about exchange rate or markets or something, I always say ki I would be foolish to try and predict. Nobody can predict markets. However, aapne sawal pucha, it's a genuine. Stock markets, again, it's eerie how the parallels are there globally. US mein dekh le, let's talk about the US, it's the largest market. You had a huge drop of about 25-30%. Pichle ek mahine mein, you've had a very significant retracing, markets have gone up. Similarly, Pakistan mein, you had a huge drop, I think 25-30% drop, yahan pe bhi PSX mein, PSE 100 index mein aaya tha. Uske baad kuch ek recovery aayi hai. Acha, markets, in order to understand markets, I think there are two things which are important. एक तो ये है कि मार्केट फॉर एग्जांपल पाकिस्तान मार्केट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ 550 लिस्टेड कंपनीज व्हिच इज अ स्नैपशॉट ऑफ द इकोनॉमी बट नॉट द होल इकोनॉमी सो वो एक होती है कि बैरोमीटर ऑफ द इकोनॉमी पॉसिबली नॉट मार्केट्स और एनी इन्वेस्टर्स विल रिएक्ट फॉर एग्जांपल अगर मैंने हबको का या पीएसओ का शेयर लेना है मैं हबको या पीएसओ की अर्निंग्स देखूंगा मैं जीडीपी ग्रोथ नहीं देखूंगा मैं एक्सपोर्ट्स नहीं देखूंगा मे बी फॉर अ परस्पेक्टिव आई लुक एट बट द की थिंग आई वांट टू नो इज हबको की क्या अर्निंग्स है हबको ने मुझे कितना डिविडेंड देना है सो फॉर सो द की थिंग इज हाउ आर द कंपनीज परफॉर्मिंग सो इफ यू टेक द व्यू फॉर एग्जांपल दैट पीएसओ इज गोइंग टू कीप सेलिंग पेट्रोल डीजल लुब्रिकेंट्स व्हाटएवर आज भी बेचेंगे कल भी बेचेंगे 6 महीने बाद भी बेचेंगे 6 साल बाद भी बेचेंगे सो यू दैट्स द व्यू यू टेक यू डोंट worry about other well you in order to make an educated estimate you see what the environment is but essentially markets are going to respond to earnings acha ab isme do teen cheeze hui hai pichle ek do saalon mein ek to because of the huge rise in interest rates for the leverage companies the financial cost has gone up very substantially so a lot of earnings have taken that hit however the other thing about markets is that markets are always forward looking so jo piche ho gaya wo ho gaya अब अगर आप किसी भी इन्वेस्टर को पूछें वो क्या देख रहा है इन्वेस्टर आगे देख रहा है कि अर्निंग ग्रोथ क्या है सेल्स ग्रोथ क्या है फाइनेंशियल कॉस्ट क्या है वगैरह वगैरह माय ओन फीलिंग इज एंड अगेन आई मस्ट एम्फसाइज बाय लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड प्लीज कीप इन माइंड नोबडी कैन प्रोटेक्ट मार्केट्स बिकॉज द अदर थिंग व्हिच हैपेंस विद मार्केट्स आई मे मेंशन फॉर एग्जांपल ये जो हमारा फॉल आया है पार्ट हैज टू डू विद द फॉल इन इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटी पार्टली इट हैज टू डू विद द फ्लो ऑफ फंड्स. तो यू नो लोग पूछते हैं कि जी आज मार्केट क्यों गिरी और कल मार्केट क्यों चढ़ी. इट्स एज सिंपल एज सेइंग कि जी आज बायर ज्यादा थे और कल सेलर ज्यादा. यस इन द लॉन्ग रन फंडामेंटल्स मैटर, इन द शॉर्ट रन. एंड दिस वन ऑफ द थिंग्स वी सी द TSX, अ लॉट ऑफ इट हैड टू डू विद द आउटफ्लो ऑफ फंड्स बिकॉज इमर्जिंग मार्केट्स जनरली वर बैडली हिट. So if there's a class of global funds which is invested in emerging markets, or wo funds ka flow ho raha hai outside of emerging markets towards safety, they always say in times of crisis there's this flight to safety, risk aversion bahut badh jati hai. So part of it is that mega trend. So if you ask me, Pakistan market, mera apna khayal hai ki most of the negatives have been built in. So agar earnings ka slowdown hai ya agar you know sales ka slowdown hai, I think people have already anticipated that and people have already adjusted prices to that. Now if there is a bigger surprise, and as I mentioned earlier, we have to keep monitoring the situation. We don't know if there is a bigger surprise, negative or positive, then the prices will adjust to that. But as of now, in number terms, for example, the market is trading at a PE multiple of about 5, which is cheap by historical standards, which is cheap by regional standards. So mera apna khayal hai ki sari jo bad news hai that is already in the prices. Yes, going forward we have to see ki jo kaun se sectors hain jo ke acche honge, kaun se sectors hain jo ke bure honge, that is a judgment.
जी, थैंक यू सो मच समीर अहमद साहब. वी आर गेटिंग अ प्लीथोरा ऑफ क्वेश्चंस एंड नेचुरली दैट्स व्हाई आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग देम डाउन लेफ्ट राइट एंड सेंटर, बट बिकॉज ऑफ पॉसिटी ऑफ टाइम आई थिंक वी विल जस्ट टेक टू मोर सर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम यू एंड देन वी विल कैरी फॉरवर्ड द अदर वंस एज पर योर कन्वीनियंस लेटर ऑन इंशाल्लाह पोस्ट ईद. आई वाज गेटिंग अ लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द यूथ ऑफ पाकिस्तान एंड दे वर आस्किंग दैट व्हाट ऑल्टरनेटिव्स डू यू थिंक देयर आर फॉर एम्प्लॉयमेंट for the youth in the future, in the coming months and coming year, because many students are going to be passing out from university and they're a little bit very apprehensive of the situation. So do you see any possibilities, sir, of employment or alternative employment opportunities emerging?
Ji bilkul hongi isme. The reason I mentioned these two or three sectors is I think these are the sectors where you're going to see growth. Agri value added, not your basic commodities, but agri value added, food processing, food value addition. This is one sector. Ispe already, I think, I mean, even if you look at the universe of listed companies, let's say the Nestle's and Unilever's and National Foods and so forth, but the food sector mein hai, pichle saal mein thoda slowdown aaya hai, but overall, I think that secular long-term trend is there. The other sector I would point out is this whole technology, and it's a very, very wide sector. But to be one thing is very, very clear, okay, this last 2 months has seen a huge boom in connectivity, online activity, whether it's entertainment or work or whatever. So this is broadly one sector. The third sector is, again, it's a very broad sector, could say manufacturing possibly, but even services. Is that the global supply chains? Isme jahan koi opportunity nikalti hai, it depends. So I think if you yes, it's a difficult time. Agar overall economic activity, overall economic growth negative hai, so it's a difficult time for the young workforce. Thoda sa time factor shayad, I come back to that. Think thoda sa perspective. I know it's difficult to tell young people to keep a perspective, but I think thoda sa look at it in terms of a time perspective. Okay, you're probably going through the worst period. 3 months, 6 months down the year, possibly you will have these. I mean, there's some things which are probably gone for good. I mean, airline travel. Again, when I say gone for good, airline industry stands out. Airline industry ka jo bhi hoga, it will not be the old model. It's going to be reduced travel. It's going to be travel with more space, more seating. It's therefore going to be more expensive travel, tourism, yebo. You know, these are things which will industries which will suffer. I, for example, was very gung ho on domestic tourism, but it's obvious ki isme ek slowdown hoga. Again, you'll adjust to a different model. So it's not going to die, but it's gonna do that. So I think ये जो तीन चार areas हैं, इनमें I think growth आएगी. थोड़ा सा health sector. Sorry, I haven't mentioned that health sector quite obviously. And I know from my MBA classes, some people who've gone into that health management kind of area. Hospitals, clinics, testing, radiology. These are sectors in the IG investment, including from the public sector. So these are some areas which I think stand out.
The great advice. I mean, students should be and youth should be realigning themselves and recalibrating themselves to these sectors, I think so, in the coming months. And then similarly, sir, because Sameer Saab, you're also linked with academia. Do you have any recommendations for academia to do something in the future and maybe in the next 1 year or something related to the economy of Pakistan, how they should be gearing themselves?
थोड़ी सी खैर है, आई एम नॉट ऑब्वियसली फुल टाइम, बट थोड़ा सा जो मुझे समझ आ रही है, अगेन इट्स अ ग्लोबल थिंग, इज दिस ऑनलाइन लर्निंग इज समथिंग दैट्स गोना ग्रो एक्सपोनेंशियली. आई थिंक फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर लम्स का एग्जांपल लें, तो फंडामेंटल डिसीजन वाज टेकन दैट यू नो लाइफ गोज ऑन. अब ये मिड सेमेस्टर 21 हुई है, बट वी हैव टू फिनिश द सेमेस्टर. Partly because there's a graduating class which needs to graduate on time. Even for the others, it is our duty, it is our obligation to make sure that no disruption happens. So I think if this view is taken, my own hope is that you know by the time the fall semester comes around, we'll be back to with certain precautions and possibly with certain guidelines, we may be back to physical classes. But even if we don't, I think usme this online model will also evolve. It's been a learning experience for teachers like us also, but also for the students. Apne colleague ko jo provost ki ek email aayi thi, you know, students have genuine problems. Gharon mein kisi ke paas privacy hai, kisi ke paas connectivity hai, kisi ke paas nahi hai. So you know, just having to adapt to that, and you know, being in a house and being able to concentrate and not being able to concentrate. मतलब library में पढ़ना एक चीज़ है, घर में कमरे में पढ़ना और चीज़ है. So these are all things that have to evolve. मेरा अपना ख्याल, like I said very early, with regard to learning and telemedicine, is that they will supplement the old models even if they don't entirely replace them. So there's some things that you will have to. मिसाल के तौर पे मेरे अपना जो course था international finance, one of the things I did was एक final exam था, उसकी जगह मैंने students को एक term paper दे दिया कि आप ये कर लो, you know, it just seemed more doable. So we'll see things evolving, but I think education obviously has to go on. अब उसमें कुछ mega trends आ रही हैं business education में खास तौर पे, which again students have to be aware of. Within industries, मिसाल के तौर पे, because it's my industry, the financial sector, at one time this was the glamour sector, this was the growth sector. About 8 to 10 years ago, things started changing. Is waqt ek to growth isme itni nahi hai, in the sense ke new hiring, a lot of, you know, focus aap se financial sector mein nahi ja rahe log, there's less hiring. And within that also, you know, the kind of people that are being hired are different now. The emphasis is on things like risk management, compliance. These are the areas where you're seeing growth. So you know, students obviously industry ke sath interact karein, and this is I think something that you should, as students, push the administration ke aap log hame industry ke sath thoda sa aur ek interaction ya input aaye, so that we also know where the growth is, where we should concentrate. So as I said, main message, life goes on, life will go on, things will be different, things will change. And I think all of us have to be on our toes and just to watch how things are evolving and adapt to that as best as we can.
Sameer Saab, a great session, a great discussion, great ideas. I think some positivity all around. You've been able to shed away the negativity we have been accumulating in the past 8 weeks or so. And I think that everyone who is here has now a bigger heart, and they know that it's not as it's not about the gloom doom scenario which is being pictured everywhere. However, just a short jo hai, last question. Do you think the worst is over, sir? Or
nahin, I don't think it is. I think Pakistan mein bhi agar hamari government ki aap predictions dekhe, it is expected, in medical terms, it is expected to peak around early June. So is waqt agar 20,000 cases hai, I think the expectations is this is going to grow to 150 to 200,000. Similarly, I think the number of deaths proportionally will go up. So we're certainly not through the peak. We're still in that growth, possibly exponential growth. However, I think the key thing for the government, all of us will be to see, okay, as per the expectations, agar hai, to it, you can say it's a bit controllable. One of the things the government has to do is just ramp up the testing. Testing make the true numbers aayenge samne. Secondly, I keep coming to this point of data. Testing is going to give you a lot of data. Is gaon mein hai, is shahar mein hai, is industry mein hai. What do you need to isolate? What do you need to take apart? Who do you need to protect? So no, unfortunately, we're not through the worst. Agar iski positive spin hai, to wo ye hai ki I think we have a better grip on the problem. We know what to look for. So that hopefully the policy response will be educated rather than just floundering.
Inshallah, sir. Thank you so much, sir. On behalf of Ann Foundation and on behalf of LUMS, I would like to thank you. I'm very grateful for this very enlightening discussion, mind-opening and also very positive. It's all about the opportunities which are there. We have many challenges, but the opportunities are also over there. I hope that many of the people from the audience would take back many ideas from you. And realign their strategies for the future. And again, sir, we are very grateful that you took your time out. And I'm very grateful to all of the audience who was a part of this and were also jotting down many questions while Samir Ahmed Saab was speaking. And we can all look towards a better and a stronger and a more economically stable Pakistan in the future, with its hiccups also and the impediments, but we will have to get together to move forward in a better way. So thank you, everyone. Thank you so much, Samir Saab. Thank you, Ann Foundation. Pakistan, Zindabad, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.